gets me stupid, gets me drunk. I'll do anything that you want. I don't think I ever recorded an intro for this video. If I did, I think I deleted it. If you guys saw the first video, I obviously got engaged and got married, which was the first part. And then the second part was after we got married, we knew we were gonna move across the country. This is me documenting the moving part of our journey. Yeah, so hope you guys enjoy seeing my journey.
We are packing some stuff that we know we won't need in the move, because several people have said they're already interested in the house, and obviously we already have a house we're moving into. I went ahead and already organized the bathroom. I've done a lot of cleaning. I got rid of 6 bags of clothes. So we're doing a lot, but I'm not recording it because otherwise this video would just be straight montages of me cleaning, and I think that's so boring. But if it wasn't montages, it'd be even more boring, because then it's just slowly watching me clean. But let's get started. Right in front of the camera.
Oh, I didn't realize you were filming.
Well, I've been trying to document the moving process.
Yeah.
Because it's like kind of interesting, because I never remembered moving before. This is my first time like actually having memory of moving. But we had to move the futon out of the room. Why does this shot look so weird?
I think I'm just
the realtor said we had to move my dresser over here to over here, which is weird because it has a TV on it, but you know, you have to do what your realtor says. Everything looks so empty. This process has been really annoying because basically you just can't live life like enjoyably, because you can't eat, you can't cook, because you don't want to dirty the oven. You don't want to have too much dirty laundry. You can't really do laundry because you don't want the laundry to be dirty. When you take a shower, you can't have dirty towels. When you do your makeup, you have to put it away immediately and like put it in the... You just put stuff where it shouldn't be normally, and just like act like you're not... Like you can't live your life like normally.
Not because if we're in an apartment or like a hotel.
Yeah, because it's like not your space anymore because you're trying to sell it to someone else. So. This is my room now. So empty. This is what showing a house is like.
Are we gonna go to the park? Are we gonna go to the park?
By the way, I have orange hair now. Looking spoopy-ish every day, and I'm here for it. This is what we're dealing with right now. So we got rid of that cabinet and put all my clothes in boxes, and we're gonna get rid of this too. And then we got rid of my bed frame because we're selling it. We're probably gonna sell my mattress too. So right now we're sleeping on the floor with our TV that's on the floor. Let me go back to the mirrors. I'm so ready to be out of here. I'm so ready, like, cause none of our stuff, like we're packing up our stuff. It's boring. I don't wanna be here for another 3 weeks, but my dad said I might be able to go April 1st, which is an A week. And if I can, I'm gonna take the opportunity, cause yeah, I wanna be out of here, so. I always remember moving so fondly, but then when I actually move, I'm like, wow, this sucks so bad. This is our first time seeing the room since everything is gone. What is this? Where'd you go? You can tell she's just like confused, because she's like, I used to live here, but it's been so hard not having her like in my room. Today is it. It's the day we're moving out. My room is empty. Everything is getting empty. The pot is coming. Our cars are going. It's all happening today. And then we leave tomorrow. It's a surreal feeling, but I have to say, I'm so ready to leave. Like, I don't know, but yeah, I'm just ready to go. I'm ready to start my new life. And I don't know, I kind of feel like we all know what moving looks like. The house is empty and we're leaving. So I didn't really know what else to film, but this is it. This is it.
As I looked back at my empty room, my empty house, for once I was old enough to actually realize how much a house means or how much a place can mean. This room is where I hung out with my husband for the first time, where I used to stink around with my friends, where I filmed a million YouTube videos, where I decorated for every holiday, where I lived with my first bunnies, where I watched a million movies and ate a million meals, where my husband and I got ready on our wedding day, where my husband and I moved in together and shared a room for the first time. And then, as the days were coming to a close, I went to places I used to go around Franklin and realized how much this place used to mean to me. Downtown Franklin, where I used to walk around in middle school with my friends because there was nothing better to do. The mall, a place where I went to pick up one thing and always ended up getting food. The train tracks, where I started to discover my love for pictures and photography, even if I wasn't any good at it. When I came here, I had so much room to develop and so much to learn. So while I am beyond ready to leave Franklin and move on, I can never forget the place that let me meet my bestest friends, my future husband, my future family, and just create a whole new life for myself. I'm happy that I said goodbye in the best way I could, and as I move on, I will always remember this place as a home for this crucial part of my life. Goodbye, Tennessee. I'm ready for my new home now.
That you do, nah, nah, nah.